Previously on B-Roll.
A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
It is a period of civil war, but the galaxy spins on, and in the Outer Rim, lawlessness reigns.
I had a meeting with the Hutts. I'm meeting my milliflower dealer.
He's acting very weird. As you look back up, he's gone.
What are you drinking for?
There are some aberrations in this person. There's a pair meeting.
I follow them.
As you turn down the alleyway, they're gone.
I want to know where the person you met with is heading.
He left planet, went further spinward. The strangers departed Nar Shaddaa, each finding their way off-world on the very same ship. The Gibbous. This man in front of you is of the Zeltron race, known for exuding a pheromone that is intoxicating. Probably a free space in the cargo.
Sure. Let's take a look around the cockpit.
All the other noise of the ship fades away. You seem to see and hear inside this room. Hi, I'm the first mate. Hey, get out.
I storm off.
You see a child.
What's her name?
Missa.
I think she's a stowaway. We were just pulled out of hyperspace.
Tell them to give up the criminal they're harboring.
Skirk, no secret you're thinking of leaving. Take old Uggy with you, all right?
Uggy, you are a piece of bantapoodoo. All right, come on.
Can I ready a smoke grenade?
I shoot it, and I'm like, hey, anybody want to play a game?
I slap him. You said to shut up!
The top hatch slips open.
I'm here for a bounty by the name of Zell.
You see Nazi Pickpick raise his trank gun, and Zed collapses.
What was that for?
He's a threat.
What do you want me to do?
Just pretend like you don't know what's going on, and when the Jawa starts shooting things, you shoot at the same things.
The Jawa lands with a squeak, and something glistening rolls away. A crystal, like a supernova captured in a looking glass. You find it impossible to look away from.
What was that?
It's mine. I am going to message you, tell you what this is.
Someone help me bring Zed up to the bounty hunter.
Changelings can't keep their form when they're unconscious.
Changelings? I ready my pistol to shoot the shot. I don't want to hurt you. I just need to see if you're a changeling.
I want to get moving as much as you do.
This is against my better judgment, but I'm trusting you. Me and Zashot put Zed in a closet.
Zashot, you have his datapad. There is a symbol on the datapad. Every single light in the ship winks out.
Someone thought it'd be funny to spool up my hyperdrive. Zell, surrender yourself.
Where's Topi?
I found a small Twi'lek girl.
She's my daughter! There's a scream from the cargo hold. Missa comes running out of it. There's a crate. Inside is the bound and gagged form of Missa. You hear a blaster. Missa appears to be standing in the quarters. You notice an aberration in this person. She snarls, and she pulls open a ventilation grating and climbs in.
I get on the intercom. Turn yourself in, or I will kill everyone on this ship.
Get out of the cockpit!
Topi, I'm bluffing. I have smoke grenades. I crank the vents, and I toss a smoke grenade in them, and I follow Topi.
You are clocked over the back of the head as you see Zell tear past you out of the cargo hold towards the cockpit. Uggy comes through the docking tube.
We gotta go!
Jawa start rushing onto the Gibbous as you watch the cockpit enter hyperspace.
Someone shot our interdiction field generator.
Zashot, what happened?
This is all your fault. Now we don't have a cockpit.
You're telling me my bounty took off of that thing?
Defaulting, did you know that your cockpit could do that?
This ship, let's just say I recently acquired it.
The bounty hunter's ship enters hyperspace.
What do we do now? The engine room would probably be a good start.
Aggie, come back!
I take off my hat and I throw it down.
Uh-oh. Life support is off.
Do you think you can get it up and running again?
I need schematics.
You can look in here, I just...
Do you have anything in there that will help us?
I make weapons. There is a crate melted open.
I turn on my flashlight.
In a cranny is what looks like the head of a mop.
And you think you can hear it snoring.
Why don't we give it a little sniff?
It purrs.
Fear effect. We have emitter on our ship. They breed very quickly.
Skirk, you seize a shot.
I have a proposition for you. 3,000 credits. If you off the captain, I'll give you that.
You got a deal.
You lift up the panel. You seem to be in the bowels of the Gibbous. You make it to under the left quarters. There's an emergency sleeping roll and a couple clumps of hair. Maru, you bump into Nasi.
I have a proposal. We mutiny. You won't have to wander the galaxy.
All right.
Uggy, take off the hat.
Not now, Skirk!
You all find schematics of the gibbous as it passes between different owners. Falchung falls to the floor. Zed is pointing a blaster towards him. But that's not where Zed is. Zed is next to you.
Nasi stabs Falchung with a toxic dart.
You find the crystal. Your mind suddenly returns to Oma Dun. You hear the screams of Missa and they become your own.
Nasi does what he needs to save Falchung.
She goes to throw another punch.
This Zed falls to the floor. The magenta skin fades into a sickly green.
That's a Claudite! Thankfully, that bounty hunter went off following the cockpit.
Skirt, keep an eye on the door.
Not sure I can keep my eye on the door and the captain.
She has no idea what you're talking about.
Nasi, we were going to mutiny.
Mutiny?
It was that changeling.
You examine Falchung. He does not need to be in a coma.
What did you do to him?
Would you like me to tell everyone?
Then I'll tell them what you have done.
What did you take from the captain?
Nasi pulls out the gem.
The gibbous falls out of hyperspace, and before it is a colossal space station. Welcome to Hub. This is our stop.
Yeah, Nasi's ready to get going. He's at the front door.
Topi opens.
Hey, wait, yeah,
Topi opens the ramp to lead off. It lowers down and you see the hangar bay. You can finally get off this accursed ship.
Yeah. As Nasi walks past Falchung, he's like, remind me not to take fares from people that steal ships. If I ever say I'm going to do that, please stop me.
Remind me not to accept passengers who steal their captain's possessions.
Remind me not to.
I'm not.
Save the life.
I'm not escalating.
Hey, just keep walking, man. Keep walking.
I'm not escalating this conversation, Gungan.
Could you step to the side? I need to get through here.
This is not how I wanted this to go.
I don't think this isn't how I wanted to. This is not how anyone. I told you guys already. This adventure's supposed to end with you guys being friends.
Sorry. Have you guys seen the videos where people are like insulting their friends and they're like, it's the big nose for me? And it's like they're insulting them by just like calling out the things that they're making fun of. That's what that interacts. It's the stealing ships from me. It's the stealing possessions from me.
Yeah. My great fault saving people I was about to murder.
Yeah. Great job, man.
Thanks.
You jerk.
That's what I get for being nice. Nasi's just like, whatever. And Nasi goes to an exit, like, far away, but doesn't go through it. He wants to observe where everyone's going.
So you step out into the hangar, but you're watching everybody.
Yeah, oh yeah, sorry. I step out in the hangar and kind of lurk by an exit. Right.
Zashat exits and looks over to the captain and Topi and just kind of gives like a silent but thankful like head gesture.
Topi and Falchung both do it back.
And then proceeds to exit.
Skirk kind of copies her by tipping his hat.
Muru falls after and also nods his head.
And then I say, wait. We're all working together on this bounty thing here, right?
Oh, right. There's a bounty.
Who's that?
Oh, right.
Oh, my God. Nazi was not.
I forget.
Wait, hold up. I'm going to stop.
Topi.
Yeah.
Topi raises his hand. I'll contact you all.
We all exchanged phone numbers before we left.
Yeah. Hey, so what's your number, cutie?
We have a Google Hangouts chat. A Galaxy Google Hangout.
Boy, you know what? We should all do an RPG sometime.
Oh my goodness.
Too meta.
Falchung, you can write it.
Volchung would be a terrible writer. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
I promise I won't be too busy.
Joinks. Joinker.
Okay, so do you all want to, like, what do you want to do about?
Is it fine just going off of what I said? You mean about the bounty?
What do you mean?
Well, I don't know if we all trust him. Do we all trust him?
Yeah.
Or should we move on, Pat? Because I don't want to add another argument.
Yeah.
So should we just say we all trust him?
I think we should all kind of trust him. No, I mean, yeah. Nasty's watching everyone so he can...
I mean, given us some reason not to trust him. It's like the only person that has been sort of trustworthy.
Yeah. So Topi says, I'll contact you all about the bounty. And Faltering just kind of looks at him. He's like, excuse me. And you all exit the Gibbous. The ship. The ship that's supposed to be yours eventually.
Yeah, I was gonna say, can we say that we want a rendezvous back at the
I mean, he said he'd contact you, so.
Like,
well, how will you? Okay, we'll go with that.
It's up to
there
you.
Might be like a curry.
Yeah, no. It's.
Seems logical. Nasty's just happy he's not locked up with Zell, honestly.
Yeah. Fat middle finger to Zell.
Jerk. Screw that guy. Wait. Yeah, no, Zell's a guy. Right? Zell is a male.
They're
person.
Probably gender fluid because they can swap.
Yeah.
Maybe? I don't know.
Zero. Y'all haven't asked.
By the way, sir, what are your pronouns? And then clocks. Like,
fuck you.
Clocks him out. Oh, well, thank you for asking.
My pronouns are fuck you.
Okay. A little vulgar, but all right. We respect your decisions.
Your mom's vulgar.
You're right.
So you all leave the Gibbous. Where do you go?
I head to the nearest bar.
Yeah, Nasim follows Maru to the nearest
you,
bar.
You leave the hangar and you enter a massive area, tall with a sloped ceiling, its hull stretching into the distance, curving beyond view. Arrivals checkpoints line the room, same as any old port, and several guards in various models of heavily protective armor, all painted purple, stand before and behind ray shields, barring entry further into the station. I assume you go up to an arrivals checkpoint.
Yes.
This is TSA simulator. Now,
oh,
welcome to the airport. Provide appropriate identification and register yourself as a visitor of the station. Leave your weapons on your ship, or for a fee, stow any and all heavy weaponry with us for safekeeping to be returned when you leave the station. With a fee, small blasters or other sidearms may be kept. Obey the king's law.
How much is the fee?
75 per item.
Do I have money?
I have 48.
Yeah, I don't think Maru has enough.
Oh,
no.
Well, okay, yeah, go ahead.
I don't know if Skirk does either. How much does Skirk have?
I don't know if any of us do.
Skirk doesn't have money.
Sucks to suck, guys. The shop gives them the money.
Actually,
Nasi has money. Nasi has a ton of money. Skirk has enough for one of his blasters. Just one. And Shot has plenty.
Rich boys gang, let's go.
We need more than 20%.
Nasi comes up behind Maru and is like, I've got it.
Oh.
Yeah, no. Don't be happy yet. Nasi's not happy with you. He's doing this so he can fuck you up.
Wait, how is he gonna fuck me up by giving me my weapon?
No, it's hold.
Oh, that's like, for later.
He's angry, so he I don't know. I haven't really decided what he wants to do, but he will pay your gun fee.
He does it with a seething smile.
A seething smile.
Here.
Just stares right at her and hands it without looking.
Okay then.
Yeah, so I've got it.
If I'm correct, you each only have one blaster, yes?
I'm assuming my toxic grenades and gas grenades would be boarded.
Oh yeah, those would be heavy weaponry, in fact. So he
would they? How much is that fee?
Ask him. Yeah, the guard points at you're pulling out your gear and he points at those.
The bombs will have to stay. Or stow them back on the ship.
All right. I'll be back in a minute. And also, Nasi has not paid for Maru's fee yet, so she can't go through. Because he wants to follow her. Nasi goes and stores them on the ship.
All right. You're back on the ship, and Falchung and Topi are just talking in a corner, and you just toss them in a quarter? In one of the quarters?
Yeah. Yeah. Hidden, if I can just be like, oh yeah, they're...
Falchung just raises an eyebrow at you.
It's too expensive to board.
All right, and back...
Okay.
He doesn't say anything. He doesn't want to talk
okay.
to you. All right, and you're back at the checkpoint, and you pay for Maru's fee. So that is... And yours.
Yeah, that's 150.
Yep.
Dude, my individual shot gloves... Does that count as two? Or
yeah,
maybe. Let's see. You go up to an arrivals checkpoint. What are you? Are you gonna try and hide them, or are you gonna try to pay for them?
Well, my shock gloves, when they're not activated, don't appear as weapons. So
you're just gonna like. Put your hands by your side and just try to walk through. You still had. Oh no, you gave Zed's blaster to Zed.
Yeah. No. Do you charge gloves as a pair or individually? Shock gloves.
Oh, that will be individually, miss.
She removes them and then pays. All
right, that's 100. That's 150. And you are allowed to bring your gloves in.
Okay.
Skirk, you're...
Oh, sorry. I thought you meant, like, board, like, they would... Never mind. Continue.
Yeah, no, the heavy weaponry, they keep. And they can keep it safe for you. Small items right. You get to bring in with you. All right, Skirk, you're right behind the shot.
I want to say something here, but I'm thinking of it right now. as I walk past, I say, "Hey, you," and I tip my hat politely and walk away in another direction. I'm going to find a drug dealer.
You got to go through the arrivals checkpoint, my man.
Bro, come on. I'm right here.
You ain't got nothing, dude.
But I can. I still got 150
you
credit.
You gotta go through the arrivals checkpoint, Skirk.
Anyway.
Oh, okay. I go through it.
Okay. So like I said, you're right behind the shot.
Yeah.
And do you put your blasters up or do you try to hide them? Are you just gonna waltz right through?
I pull out. Let's see. What do I have for weapons? I have a small one, right?
You have two heavy blaster pistols, if I recall.
And I have a small, tiny one.
Do you?
That's disposable after one shot.
Oh right, yeah. You have the 12 Defender. You have the little. Yep. I forgot. You have a little Derringer. I totally forgot about that. Yeah, that you can. You can actually try to conceal that thing. I think that's part of the whole point.
They don't want to see my guns.
No, I think specifically the Derringer you can try to hide. The little blaster.
Oh, okay. I was going to say maybe he'd pull it out and be like, this one's my size.
It's up to you. If you want to pull out all three and try to pay for them, how do you want to approach this? Do you want to hide something? Do you want to... Just put it all on the table.
There's a shot going through, right?
Yeah, she's right in front of you. She just paid for her shot gloves.
I'm going to say, I'm with her. She knows me. I don't got nothing on me. Right? Old friend.
The guard sighs.
Little Jawa, I see you blasters.
Come on. I don't know what you're talking about.
They're right there.
Where?
He pulls out a rifle and he points it at you.
Jawa.
Oh, you mean these?
Oh, you mean these?
Yes.
He smiles and he lowers his rifle.
Oh, don't forget this one. I pull out the little one too.
Oh, okay.
I wish I had like 50 and I could just keep pulling them out.
That will be 225 for the lot.
Do I have that much money?
I don't think so.
Yeah, no, it's a big fat zero.
Hey, yeah, what time do you get off?
What?
You don't finish the black by any chance, do you?
King's law forbids bribing the guards. You want to be tossed in the brig, Joa?
It's happened before. I've been fine.
This is a shot. Do you want to do anything about this?
Hey, old pal, I could use a little help. Old friend.
Buddy, old pal. Not made of money!
The guard looks at his nails, almost like he's thinking,
you know, I could cut you a deal. I'll let you stow all your weapons for 25 credits each. How's that?
I like you. And I don't say that very often. And I tip my hat.
Do you pay the man 75 credits?
I mean, I have 0 credits. So.
I thought you had 100 credits.
Oh. Wait, what? No, that's credits. Odin. I have 100 credits.
Oh, I'm dummy, yeah, dummy thick.
I'll pay him.
Oh.
Bro, you're loaded. Yeah, I pay the man.
All right. Yeah, they stow your blasters in a secure crate.
Pleasure doing business with
that
you.
Crate, just want to make sure that crate, no one's touching it, right? Not a single mark, scratch on those guns.
Not so, my friend. Enjoy the station.
I tip my hat.
And remember, as you go through the ray shield, obey the king's law.
Hey, yeah, you too.
He just kind of shakes his head. Enjoy your movie, sir. You too. Ah, damn it. Happy birthday. You too. Ah.
No.
Dang. So you just gotta have confidence.
Right. So all 4 of you are through the checkpoints, if I am reading this correctly.
Yeah, me and Maru hitting up the bars.
All right, you cross the thresholds into the station proper. Huge corridors, lines of branching doors teasing at the hallways and rooms they guard. Throngs of people from all walks of life, all corners of the galaxy walk the deck. Little messenger droids on wheels scurry around the polished but forgivably scuffed floor, weaving through crowds in between feet. Droids hovering on repulsor lifts fly above the crowd, some casting advertisements, projecting holos, some just in a hurry to get somewhere. Shopkeepers and automated vendors promote their stock, a cacophony of noise, a mess of smells, a smorgasbord of sights and colors. It's a bustling center of civilization, and this is just the outer section of the station. Where do you all want to go? Welcome to the hub world.
Yeah, finally!
It's like when you're going on a road trip and you step out of the car and you just like stretch.
Yep. Solid ground.
Quick trick time.
It only took us 6 weeks to get here. More than that.
Yoink.
Yeah, a lot.
It's been years.
It's been years.
It's been 7 years.
Yo, Maru, you want to go clubbing? I mean, bar hopping? Bar hopping.
Yeah, man.
Wait, hold on. Say it in character, please.
Why is
Nasi asking this?
Yeah, seriously, I'm so.
No, he wants to go. He wants to go to a bar with Maru.
Yeah, but
right, say it in character. Just yeah, let's do it.
Yeah.
We'll see your reason later.
Hey, Maru, you want to go get a drink?
I look at him with an odd look. Well, sure.
All right, let's go. Where is there a bar like near the entrance?
Do you want there to be?
Sure.
All right. So, audience, welcome to the way that we're doing the hub world. I've told them all a little bit about this. Basically, as long as it makes sense, anything they want to exist in this hub world will exist here. I want them to have a hand in creating this place and the geography of it. And obviously, they can't just go, oh yeah, there's a store selling lightsabers for 1 credit each. But if it makes sense, if they, like a bar at the arrivals checkpoint. That makes sense. That could totally happen. So yeah, that exists now. That's here. I want them to help make the station, and that's what they're doing. So yeah, you see a little corner bar right to the side of the checkpoints. And who owns this bar? What kind of alien? Or do we want to just roll randomly using the gleep glop function in the dice roller to randomly create an alien?
I want to do that. That sounds fun. All right.
Ian, click on gleep glop.
There it is. Okay.
Okay. No. A wild Claudite appears. No. All right. No, we can't do that. We can't. All right. Remy.
It's like right now.
Remy, you roll this time. We're going to mulligan that. What are the odds? A wild whippet? What's a whippet? It's a Pokemon joke.
Wild. Oh. Oh, okay.
Nice.
All right, I want to see if these guys are, like, sentient, or if they're just, like, really, really stupid.
It says they're primitive and tribal.
Hmm?
It says they're primitive and tribal.
Are you looking at the Wikipedia page?
Yeah, I told you not to do that, Remy.
We definitely have an old.
All right, so there's a very tall creature drenched in really long fur with huge tusks out of a very, very long extended jaw and huge nostrils. And its eyes are small slits covered, barely seen behind fur. And you walk over and he sets down a massive mug on the bar.
Welcome! What could I get you?
What alcohol is there?
I'm not familiar with
what's
alcohol.
What's the hardest alcohol I can drink? Like,
what's the hardest alcohol? Say that. Just say that.
Hardest? No, I ain't paying for that shit.
What's the hardest you've got?
Oh, okay.
You want the hardest? That'll knock you to the floor.
Well, perhaps the second hardest, then.
Still gonna knock you to the floor.
Yeah, no, we'll just take a bottle of whatever Star Wars vodka is.
Don't say something in character, please.
No, okay, sorry, I should ask you first. What's like Star Wars vodka?
What is Star Wars vodka? I don't know what Star Wars vodka is.
Blue milk.
Let me look up alcohol.
Can I just say vodka for now?
We'll
fix it in post.
Sure. He. Yeah. Say it.
We'll just take a bottle of vodka, please.
All right.
Is there like a corner booth or something?
Yeah.
Cool. We go to that one.
Yeah. It's actually. This whole bar is themed like an ice world. All the seats are made of a blue glass, and there's like dry ice all along the floor.
Ooh, that's pretty cool.
And he sets down two large mugs with a frosty white liquid inside.
That will be 15 each.
Wait, each? I asked for a bottle. That was out of character.
I thought you wanted to split it.
Wait, what?
I thought you wanted to split it. All right, so never mind. He sets down a very large bottle filled with a frosty, clear liquid.
That'll be 25.
I give him 25 credits.
Pleasure serving ya.
Also, look at Discord. So basically, I think I messed up how much money I have. Like, on my sheet, I'm not sure exactly how much I have. So how much do you have me having?
Oh,
I've been, like, messaging you to look at Discord.
I don't have a copy of your character sheet, actually.
Okay, great. Because I have, for some reason, written down my starting credits, which is a lot more than what I actually have.
On the back of your sheet, you did like a whole like receipt thing.
Yeah, no, you're right.
Recording
bro.
How much?
Yeah.
Didn't you end up with like 500 or something?
I have 150 now after all the stuff. So 25. That's okay. I can do that.
Why are you doing this? I'm so confused.
All right. Yeah, you sit down at a corner booth, and do you? How do you feel about this?
Nasi pops the cork or whatever and pours himself a drink. Pours a drink into two glasses.
Make a coordination check.
Nasi pours the entire bottle.
Anyways, continue.
I don't know. Sorry, I'm just... Nasi takes a big drink.
So, I drink as well.
It's like...
Yeah, yeah.
This is how a date with me would go. So,
what are your plans now? Now that you don't have a fake me promising you a future.
Well... I'm not entirely certain.
I had planned on trying to find a way off this place with my newly acquired gem, but...
Can I make a check real quick to see if he's poisoned by alcohol?
Reasonable concern.
What's the check for poison check?
No.
Would it be like a perception or something?
I guess it's a perception. Yeah, I don't know. Average perception check. All right. Ian, unless I'm incorrect, you did not poison her drink.
Yeah, no, I didn't poison.
Yeah, no, it's fine. It's fine.
Like, good thought. I may in the future try to poison you, but not today.
Okay. Just making sure, because if poison's kind of your thing, and you're not exactly so happy with me right now.
You're a little sneaky.
Yeah. Well, very good concern.
You're a little suspect.
Nasi definitely thought about it.
I was like, I'm a little scarred from my poisoning that I did earlier.
My first crit fail.
Okay, where are we?
Anyway, yeah. So, yeah, I'm not sure what I'm going to do. I know this is confusing. I kind of just wanted a drinking buddy, because that whole business did not go at all. It was supposed to be an easy trip to Tordaria, and it wasn't.
Yes, same for me. Shall we forget what has happened?
It'll be hard, but we will. Nasi holds up his glass and says, to the future.
To the future.
And they clink glasses!
The whippet behind the bar pulls out a big drink and points it at you, a big bottle of like red liquid, and points it at you, and he says,
you want to forget? Try this!
Yo!
Alright.
Oh, man.
Alright, it's a shot.
For real. Like, hey, like, how much is that stuff? We're taking it, bro.
It's way too expensive.
Dang.
Oh, my.
Alright, it's a shot.
Out of the bar, completely wasted. Zashot heads towards the nearby weapon outlet.
All right, what kind of weapons are you looking for? Like, what are you?
Some sort of melee weapon.
All right, do you want to go for a shop that like specializes in melee weapons, or like a general store?
Let's go to a melee specific.
Sure. All right, so you search along the halls for a little bit. And you find, a little shop with, roll Gleep Glop, please. And let's see what alien runs this shop. Dresselian. What's a Dresselian? I don't actually know. What's a Dresselian?
It's a dressmaker.
Say yes to the dress, Elian.
Say yes to the dress, Elian. Say yes, Elian, to the dress, Elian. All right. There's a shop with like a bunch of vibro blades just hanging from the ceiling. It's practically a maze to just navigate through all these weapons hanging from this curved ceiling. And behind a counter made of jagged metal is a tall, thin creature with beige colored skin and a wrinkled, almost pruned face. And she says,
what can I get for you?
I was wondering if you had any melee stun weapons? Or melee weapons with stun capabilities?
Hey, we got lots of that. You looking for an axe, a sword? What do you want?
Lucas, what are the things called where it's like, it's not an axe, but it's like pretty much something you just hit someone with? It's not like a
club?
I thought there was like a special word for it.
A blunt weapon?
Yes. Not like a jagged blade weapon.
Yeah, like a blunt weapon. A bludgeoning weapon.
I could have sworn that there was like a more like
mace? Like a mace? You want a mace, a flail, a staff, a baton,
staff.
A truncheon. All right, she comes out from behind the counter and she pulls out a tray that's inlaid in the wall, and it's very long and inset into molded cushions in the drawer are very, very long staffs of various types.
This is my proud collection of electro staffs.
Very nice. I look over them. What are your price ranges for these?
Oh, these will run you anywhere from 1,000 to 5,000.
These are quite magnificent, but the work I do I go through my weapons. I was wondering if you had any lower quality, not as prestigious as these.
She slides the tray closed and just reaches up like blindly into the ceiling and pulls down a baton and holds it towards you.
This'll be 500.
It's a stun baton.
Can I inspect to see like its stats?
Yeah, so this'll be it has 2 hard points. It does 2 damage, brawn +2. It has a critical of 4. And it has the qualities Cumbersome 3, Disorient 2, and Stun 3. So Cumbersome 3 means you need to have 3 brawn to be able to wield it without an issue, and you do, so that's no problem. And Disorient 2 means, I believe, with 2 advantage, you can disorient a person you hit with it for 2 rounds, which gives them a setback die, I believe. Unless it's something else, I forget. It's either that or something more substantial. And Stun 3 is the same as your shock gloves. With 2 advantage, you can deal 3 strain damage.
Okay. So we're working with Encumbrance now?
No, Cumbersome 3 is completely separate from Encumbrance. It's Encumbrance rating is 3, but we're not dealing with that. Cumbersome 3 just means you have to have a certain number of brawn to be able to wield it without setback die. If you had 2, you would have 1 setback die every time you tried to swing with it, I believe.
Gotcha. Well, it is a good thing I'm strong.
Yes, you are strong.
After looking it over, wait, am I allowed to like pick it up and like?
She lets you.
Okay. Okay. After picking it up and inspecting it, she looks back to the shopkeeper and says, "I'll take this one."
Good choice. Good choice. 500 credits.
The shot takes the credits from the
pouch.
If
you want, you can make a negotiation check, which is a whole new thing we haven't dealt with yet.
Right.
Yes, so it is going to be it has to do with rarity. It's something ridiculous like that. I hate the way selling stuff works in this game. selling and buying. It's rarity 3, which means it is a easy check. So 1 purple and your negotiation skill, unless you want to be like deceitful about the way you negotiate with this person.
And that would be then a deception check?
Yes.
I'm better at perception. Negotiation. So yeah. I'll go with that.
Yeah, you... All right, try to talk her down.
For this quality of baton, it really shouldn't be 500. It is still good, but...
This quality! She snatches it and starts looking at it frantically. But... And she starts looking around the shop and she's just like having a mental breakdown. low quality! And she breathes and she... she turns back to you and she hands it out and she says...
100.
Dumb.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Likewise.
And I assume you leave?
Yeah, after glancing around and dodging out of the way of the haphazardous decorum of the way that the shop is laid out, yes, she exits the store.
All right. So you leave Freedom Fighters, the store Freedom Fighters, emblazoned over the entryway, with made out of blades.
Yeah.
And now you have a stun baton. Yeah, you got a ridiculously good roll. You got 3 success and a triumph. So,
yeah.
And a threat, but honestly, the triumph just kind of blows that out of the water. Normally, the way negotiation rolls work is the price will lower or increase depending on, you know, selling or buying based on how many successes you get. And with 3 successes, you get to lower the buying price to like like a quarter of what you were buying it from. And you got a triumph, so I was just like, yeah, whatever. You like nailed that. She's apparently like really fragile. All right, Skirk, what do you do?
So I don't know if you'll approve this or not, but this is what I was thinking. Do I just go over it with you right now?
Yeah. What are you gonna do?
Where I want to go?
Yeah.
So you know the opera in Revenge of the Sith?
Okay. Yeah.
I want Skirk. So Skirk is walking down the halls. He's like trying to find. He peeks under his robes and he sees his drugs that he picked up on the ship in the tunnels. Make sure they're still there. Safe.
Wait, what?
Oh, you remember that?
Yeah, I found some. Like,
oh, right.
Some crystal meth down there.
Oh, you mean
so? It's in my.
Okay, that's cool.
It's in my robe.
Right. I remember that happened.
I think there's like, I don't know what there is. Maybe they're like, you know, signposts saying where things are. And he's looking for. Yeah. He's looking for a place where he can trade it in. And then he sees there's an opera, and he's feeling rather thoughtful because he just left his crew. And he's thinking about his place in the world. How small he feels right now, but also he wants to be part of something bigger.
Okay.
So there's like maybe a little classical theme plays as Skirk sneaks into the opera.
Skirk's going on a freaking walkabout. All right. Yeah. You walk into a giant amphitheater, and in the center there is, let's see. I'm going to gleep glop to see who's there's a hut opera in the center of this amphitheater.
Perfect, because I'm from Tatooine.
And there are huts dressed in bizarre costumes on a round stage, and they are belting it. It's actually kind of beautiful. And you what do you do?
I picture like a wide shot and the camera just slowly pulls out as Skirk sort of sits there, eyes glazed over.
Tearing up.
Okay, yeah. You're not, that's not actually happening. Okay, what are you actually doing?
I don't know. I'm sitting there and just watching.
Did he get in?
Is there someone like all dressed up wearing a big dress or something walking in?
What, are you gonna hide under someone's dress? Yes. Oh my god! So you see, you're watching through this window, this opera, and there's a Ticketmaster standing there. He's tall and prim. he looks at you and he just raises an eyebrow.
Hey, no worries. I never judge a man by his height.
I see he's a little tall.
He must feel insecure.
His
about
eyebrow
that.
Is simply still raised.
Well, you're gonna let me in?
You have to pay the price for entry.
Gotta pay? I was invited personally.
Do you want to make a deception check?
Just check. Yeah, let's do that.
I don't know, whatever. Make an average check. Make an average deception check. Did not expect
this show is called the Prancing Jawa. So they're like, oh, maybe.
This is utterly strange. Yeah, you have no points in deception, unless I'm reading that wrong.
No, but I do have 3
He's cunning. Really trying to get arrested.
But you do have 3 cunning. All right. Yeah, you failed with 3 advantage. So
wait, can he destiny point this shit?
You already rolled. I'm gonna take that first roll. He looks at you and He switches eyebrows. The one currently raised lowers and the other one raises. And he opens the door and he says,
"You may watch briefly."
When it's fine art, it can be brief. You know? That's all I need. Thanks, pal.
Don't test my hat. Don't test my patience.
I'm already walking away.
You're walking in? Yeah.
The show. Yeah, I'm walking in.
All right, you walk in. Yeah, and there's these huts in really gorgeous outfits singing shockingly beautifully. What else happens, man? I don't know. You're in charge of this.
I walk up to a richly dressed do you want to do a little?
Yeah, do a little gleep glop.
Roll.
Throw a little gleep glop in there. Okay. Oh, richly dressed Nikto. Oh, that's weird. Nikto are, Bryce, you as Skirk would know this. Nikto are famous for always being the lowly thugs of huts. They are a race commonly enslaved by the huts, working as just standard thugs. So you see a Nikto in really elegant garb.
So what'd you have to do to get here? You know, there was a hut that had a thing for me once.
He looks to you and he goes, "Shh."
Oh, sorry. You want to know how I got out of that one?
This is weird. He just looks around. It's like,
"We're watching this show."
Right. I think you just watch him.
What's the objective here, Skirk? What?
I wanted this to be a character moment.
What are we doing here?
So should I explain his inner monologue?
Sure.
As he briefly walks.
Tell me what's going on.
So Skirk, not just because he's a small, his species are small. He's always felt like a small guy in a big world. And the opera is something grand.
Oh my god.
The opera is very grand, right? And it reminds him of the world. But he also knows that he doesn't want to be a part of the big world if it means conforming to it.
Oh my god. What's happening?
So this is almost like his a metaphorical representation of his farewell to being a part of a Jawa clan. He knows there's something bigger out there for him.
Bryce with the cheesy Oscar bait.
He you know me. So he nods. He watches for a couple moments, nods, and starts to walk out. And then he freaking trips on his robes and falls over and makes a little noise.
The man, the Ticketmaster, beckons you out.
All right. I was leaving anyway. Wasn't really that great. You know, I've seen better. The best opera is on Tatooine, let me tell you.
He just kind of, he shoves you back out into the hall. All right, strange. Maru and Nasi, what are you doing?